Okay, so this is Runo 5 in our Quarantine Kalevala series. Runo 5 is actually pretty short, which is kind of nice because Runos 3 and 4 were ludicrously long, 17 and 19 minute videos respectively. So sorry about that, but I think Runo 5 is nice and bite-sized and enjoyable. So let's get started. Runo 5, The Mermaid. Now the news had been carried, and the tidings borne abroad, of the young maid's sleep, of the fair one's loss. Steady old Väinämöinen, he took it badly. He wept evenings, wept mornings, and nights most of all he wept, that the fair one had fallen, the maid had fallen asleep, gone into the wanton sea, down below the deep billows. He stepped, full of care and sighs, with a gloomy heart, to the shore of the blue sea. He uttered a word, spoke thus, "Tell now, O dreamer, your dream. O stretched in earth, your vision. Where is Ottoland? Where do his wave-wife's maids stretch?" Well, the dreamer told his dream, the stretched in earth his vision. Here is Ottoland, and here his wave-wife's maids stretch, on the misty headland's tip, at the foggy island's end, down below the deep billows, upon the black mud. There is Ottoland, and there his wave-wife's maids stretch, in a tiny room, a narrow chamber, beside a bright rock, lodged beneath a thick boulder. At that, old Väinämöinen dragged himself to the boatyards, glances at his fishing lines, and looks over his fish-hooks, put a hook in his pocket, an iron barb in his bag. He paddles along, he reaches the island's end, and the misty headland's tip, and the foggy island's end. There he stayed with the fish hook, remained with the fishing line, turned the hand net to and fro. He cast the gorge on the sea, he angled, dangled, the rod of copper trembled, the silver line whirred, and the cord of gold jingled. On a day among others, one morrow among many, a fish took his hook, a suin his barb. He pulled it into his boat, landed it upon his bilge. He looks, he turns it over, and uttered a word, spoke thus, "Now, that is a fishy fish, I never saw the like of. Rather smooth for a whitefish, rather light-hued for a trout, rather grizzled for a pike, too finless for a spawner, but weird for a person, too, too bareheaded for a maid, beltless for a water girl, too earless for a home bird, too mild for a sea salmon, a perch of the deep billow." At his belt, Väinämöinen has a silver-tipped sheath knife. He drew the knife from his side, from its sheath the silver-tipped, to divide the fish, cut up the salmon for meals at morning, for breakfast tidbits, for salmon lunches, and for big suppers. He made to cut the salmon, with the knife to slash the fish. Into the sea the salmon flashed, the bright fish flared from the bilge of the red craft out of Vinamoinen's boat. Only then it raised its head and its right shoulder upon the fifth squall, on the sixth high wave, held up its right hand, revealed its left foot on the seventh main, on top of the ninth billow. From there it put this into words. It declared, chattered, "Oh, you old Väinämöinen, I was not to be a salmon for you to cut, a fish for you to divide for meals at morning, for breakfast tidbits, for salmon lunches, and for big suppers." The old Väinämöinen said, "What were you to be?" "Well, I was to be a hen tucked under your arm, one who would sit forever, a lifelong mate on your knee, to lay out your bed, to place your pillow, to clean your small hut, one to sweep your floor, to bring fire indoors, to kindle your light, to make your thick bread, bake your honey bread, carry your beer mug, and set out your meal. I was not a sea salmon, a perch of the deep billow. I was a girl, a young maid, young Jokahainen's sister, who you hunted all your days, throughout your lifetime longed for. You wretched old man, you foolish Väinämöinen, for you knew no way to keep the wave-wife's watery maid, Otto's peerless child." The old Väinämöinen said, his head down in bad spirits, "Oh, Jokahainen's sister, come but once again." But she did not come again, not ever again. Now she drew back, flopped back, was lost from the water's surface, within the bright rock, the cleft of the liver-hued. Steady old Väinämöinen at that considers how to be, which way to live. Now he wove a silken seine, crisscrossed the water, along one strait, across two, he dragged calm waters. Between salmon crags, those waters of Väinäland, Kalevala's land bridges, dragged the gloomy depths and the main's great poles, the rivers of Jokoland and the bay shores of Lapland. He caught enough other fish, all kinds of fishes, but he did not catch the fish he'd set his heart on, the wave wife's watery maid, Otto's peerless child. Then the old Väinämöinen, his head down in bad spirits, helmet all askew, put this into words. O madman, from my madness, fool from my manhood, once I had a mind and thought was given, a great heart crammed full, now that was long ago. But now, nowadays, in this evil age, this life running short, all my mind is anyhow, my thoughts are priceless, all my sense is somewhere else. She I waited for always, and half my lifetime, the wave wife's watery maid, the water's latest daughter, to be a friend forever and a lifetime's mate, come on to my hook, flopped into my boat. I could not keep her, carry her off home, but lost again to the waves, down below the deep billows. And he went a little way, he stepped full of care and sighs, he trudges homeward. He uttered a word, spoke thus, time was when my cuckoos called, former cuckoos of my joy, used to call evenings, mornings, once at midday too. What has stifled their great voice, lost their voice so fair? Grief has stifled their great voice, care brought down their voice so sweet, because no calling is heard, and at sundown no singing to cheer my evenings, to ease my morrows. Nor do I know now at all how to be, which way to live, in this world to dwell, in these lands to roam. If my mother were alive, my parent awake, she would be able to say how to stand upright, unbroken by griefs, unstricken by cares, in these evil days, in these low spirits. From the grave his mother heard, from below the wave answered, your mother is still alive, your parent awake. She who is able to say how to be all right, unbroken by griefs, unstricken by cares in these evil days in low spirits, go among the North's daughters. There daughters are comelier, maids are twice fairer, five times, six times livelier, none of Yoko's frumps, gawky children of Lapland. Get wife from there, my boy, the best of the North's daughters, who is pretty-eyed, fair to look upon, ever fleet of foot, and brisk of movement. Väinämöinen's gonna get a date. We hope. You'll find out.